Essex, and welcome to your literacy lesson for Monday the 1st of June. This week's literacy is going to be all about stories aimed at a younger audience, so aimed at Key Stage 1 or aimed at younger siblings if you do have those and you'd like to choose those as your audience. So you'll need a pen, pencil and your exercise book. So your spellings for this week are again taken from the Year 6 challenge words. So I'm going to go through each of those in turn, repeat after me with the pronunciation, and then we'll move on to the next part. So we've got a company, average, conscience, develop, explanation, immediately, necessary, privilege, rhythm, and symbol. Great, so we're very familiar with this by now. Obviously, it's up to you how you want to present it. If you want it in a chart like this, that is fine. So you're looking at practicing writing the word, finding out the definition and its meaning, whether there's a synonym or synonyms for the word, and then trying to use it in at least one sentence. So pause the video so that you can do that. And then what I'd suggest that you now do is log on to Spelling Shed and have a bit of a practice at spelling those words through some of the games. So pause the video so you can do that for about 10 minutes. So as I said at the start, this week's literacy is going to be about making stories for a younger audience, ideally for Key Stage 1, but if you've got younger siblings that are not in that age group, you might choose to have them as your audience. That's absolutely fine. So I'd like you to see what the final product might look like, because the stories that you write in literacy are going to link to your art and your animation. So I would suggest pausing the video and having a look at what your story could eventually look something like when it's turned into an animation. And the idea behind creating these and turning them into animations is so that we can actually share them with Key Stage 1 and we can actually share them with other children, whether they're at school or whether they're at home in future weeks. So do pause the video just to have a look at those examples if you've not already. So hopefully that's something that you're looking forward to doing. There might be a couple of you sitting there and thinking, well, I don't know how to make that into an animation. If that is the case, then our art lessons do show you how to do that. If you've not watched previous art lessons, then watch those as well as this week's. And if you're sitting there thinking, well, I can't make an animation because I'm not able to do that on my device, or maybe it's that you're sharing a device, that's fine. You could always choose not to do an animation, but to do something like a picture book or maybe a comic strip in the end as your final product. So in terms of what our journey will look like, today is going to be about planning the story that you're going to be doing. On Tuesday and Wednesday, we'll write that story and focus on certain parts. And then on Thursday, we'll critique and edit that and just make it the best that that can be. And then on Friday or in your art lesson, you can then turn that story into a storyboard, into a plan for your animation. And as I said, the literacy does link very, very closely with the art. So do watch the art session as well. And my advice to you would be that you don't do the art early this week, but that you save the art until Friday, until you've done your story, until you've got everything organised and you can continue that on in following weeks. Great. So as I said, today is going to be focusing on the planning stage. So you will probably want to pause the video and have a really good think about this, because the story that you choose and that you're going to write this week needs to be something that you're going to enjoy and that you think your audience is going to enjoy as well. So my suggestion would be probably to go for a traditional tale or a fairy tale, because they're easy to remember. So maybe something like Hansel and Gretel, Cinderella, or Little Red Riding Hood, or it might be something that you really enjoyed as a child, a book that you particularly remember and that you want to create into an animation. Then you're going to want to think about, do you want to just retell it? So do you want to retell the story exactly as it was, but putting it into your own words? Or do you want to maybe rewrite the ending and change the story a little bit? You could maybe set it in the modern world, or you could set it in a different place, in a different setting, or you could maybe tell it from a different character's perspective. So rather than tell it from Cinderella's perspective, you could maybe tell it from the Ugly Stepsister's perspective. You might have another idea of how you want to change it if you do at all, and that's absolutely fine. But as I said, it needs to be something that you're going to enjoy writing and that you're going to enjoy animating as well. So pause the video just to make a little list of things or ideas that you think you could potentially do. Great, so hopefully you've got an idea of a story that you could do, or a few ideas. And what you'll now need to do is choose one of those. And with that idea, you'll need to plan out your story. So remember, are you going to just retell it? Are you going to change it a little bit? Now, you can use the plan similar to on this slide. So to create your story mountain of events, you might want to just plan it out using pictures and a few words just to support you. But you'll just need to plan it out so over the next couple of days, you know which bits that you're focusing on writing, and you know what's going to happen at the start, the middle and the end. So pause the video so that you can plan out your story today. Time.